Rivers back into the seat.
Welcome back once again to Morgantown. We're heading into the fourth quarter of play, and it is looking forward to that. Sit down and join us a little bit, and we'll talk some football here and talk some improvements. One of the things that Don Nealon talked about when he was here, Governor, was the fact how much this place has changed in the 28 years that it's been in existence. There have been a lot of improvements.
I was, and of course, I started back in 1965 playing freshman ball at WVU at the old stadium. So when this stadium was conceived in 1979, 1980, everybody thought, my goodness, we used to play golf here. It used to be
right?
A par three golf course through here. So we thought, I don't know if that's going to work. Just all of a sudden we go from 35 to 60 or 70,000 seats. And my goodness, Coach Nealon came in and took it to another level.
A nice hand because of the change offensively for West Virginia. And the highly touted Noel Devine is on the field. So we'll see what these freshmen can do. Nobody.
It's only ones I got.
More attention than Devine and Sanders. And he'll get a carry. And if you've ever watched YouTube, that was Sanders on the carry that time. You'll see a lot of Noel Devine. That's for sure.
Governor, I'm from New Orleans, and I know Rich Rodriguez when he was at Tulane, and success.
Never complain. He's still working hard. And Nick Saban, my very, very, very close friend, all of us live 2 miles apart. So Nick grew up on this side of the town. I grew up in Farmington. And
lineup is Jock Sanders along with Devine. What about the Friends of Cole Bowl? How does that work? And you said it's a big event for the city of Huntington. I know that for many years those two teams didn't play, and West Virginia really felt that it was a no-win situation for them to play Marshall, but you've changed that.
Well, I'm sure. I'm a WVU alumni, as you know, and I'm sure there's a lot of hardcore alumni that believe that it's not a win-win for us. You know, we play them in basketball, and we've proven that's a tremendous
right.
financial success. When the 12th game was added, John, I knew that to be a financial success, WVU and Marshall should be playing, and it has proved very beneficial for both. As you can see, whoever wins the first two out of three gets the fourth game at home.
Well, wasn't that always one of the hang-ups as to how many games were going to be played in each stadium? That was a critical battle that you had to take care of.
That was the final hang-up. Okay, we kept locking. I kept them in the mansion all day that day. They started with breakfast and went right through lunch and was going to dinner. And I said, guys, we got to finish this up. And Ed Passlong, tremendous friend of mine and a great guy, and K.O. Markham, they're just class act. And they worked it out. And then we talked to them. They said, we're down to this. We can't decide. West Virginia believes we should have three of the four games.
Right.
And Marshall says, well, at least you know, we should have two out of two. Let's be, you know, they
right.
went. So they said, well, where I come from in Farmington, West Virginia, two out of three usually takes it.
Well, that's a good plan. And I remember I talked to Don Nealon years ago when they played, and they put a big scare in West Virginia because they took like a 21-0 lead right here in this stadium, and then the Mountaineers roared back and beat them.
They've got a quality program. They're working hard, and Mark Snyder is a good young coach, and Bobby Pruitt just, like I said, took it to another level. But it's going to be a tremendous rivalry. We watched it in basketball.
Well, I've enjoyed that rivalry. Those games are always great down there. I've done it like 8 or 9 straight years.
Well, they beat us the 1 year. We went to the Sweet 16.
Right.
They beat us the next year.
That's
we went
right.
to Elite 8. And I said,
row.
Well, if they beat us last year, we'd have been the national champion.
You know, speaking of national championship, Governor, we have the national championship in the Superdome this year. And the way this team is playing, got two Heisman hopefuls. But we may see the Mountaineers in the Superdome January 7th.
Well, Rich has done a tremendous job with this team. And his staff needs to be commended because they've worked hard to get to this level. But you know something, this is what Rich always believed he'd be at this level. He just knew it. And I remember when they talked to him first to try to Coach Nealon decided to retire and who was going to be his successor.
Right.
Well, WVU fans are very proud of this team and they're
There's
proud.
Noel Devine.
There we go.
That's what they came to see. He's got a first down. Wow. That outstanding freshman. Noel Devine. Jock Sanders is in there. That's a 20-yard pickup for Noel Devine out of the pass by Jarrett Brown, the backup. And this is what you talked about, Governor, a little bit. You can see White and Slayton are tremendous, but there's some other kids that are coming. So they've started the process of getting good football players.
Well, how would you like to have, how many teams like to have that quarterback?
Absolutely.
Right now.
He did a great job when Patrick was hurt last year.
Oh, my goodness.
Good look at Noel Devine. What numbers he had in high school,
oh,
John.
Scary.
Wow, 92 touchdowns.
Jared Brown lost the handle on that and had to take a knee. But this program here, and again the one in Marshall as well, can make us all very proud of football in the state of West Virginia.
It really does, and it's just taken the whole scholastic to another level also. And I just I'm just so proud. And I tell them, I mean, I'm proud of the academics and our students, how well they do. But the exposure that we receive as a state from these broadcasts, and you all have done such a great job for us, and we appreciate it. It gives us the exposure that I think West Virginia needs, and it really is a different perception of who we are, and it really helps an awful lot.
Here's Devine.
There we go.
Trying to get to the edge. And that's what he did in high school. He could bounce back up. He'll get only two. Noel Devine, one of the most highly touted running backs in the country. Now watch some of this. It's almost unbelievable what this kid does.
It looked like they have him at a different speed than everyone else. And, you know, he's about a 4-3 sprinter. You know, they say it might be interesting to see a foot race between Slayton and Devine, but he has another gear. Look at this, another gear just pulls away from everyone. Great move right there. You can't slow him down. You may slow him down a little bit, but, you know, he's really loves it here. And from everyone thought he was going to Florida State, but Fort Myers, Florida, but he seems to love it here. And Rick Rodriguez sure glad he's a Mountaineer.
Brown trying to get away from some pressure. And he's going to pick up a first down. It's down to the 25-yard line. Well, you talked about it. A lot of people would like to have Brown as their quarterback.
He's so strong. And I was so impressed in Louisville last year when he had to come in, or Rutgers, I'm sorry.
First down, West Virginia.
You know, the thing about Jared Brown is, you know, he's learned his fundamentals from Adam Bednarik, but he's learned his reads and how to run an offense from Patrick White. And people think he's very similar to a Vince Young in skills and good size and tremendous arm, 6'4", 220.
The character of these young men is unbelievable, and I've been around them for a few years. They just work with each other, and they always root for each other. Very competitive, but they're always together as a team, and that's what makes them special.
Noel Devine will get a couple more as he gets inside the 25, down to about the 23-yard line. Not much there. Clock continues to roll, 9:43 remaining in the ballgame, dominated by West Virginia. They have 49 points on the board and looking for more, with primarily second-unit players in there right now.
You know, the good thing about this is these two freshmen, Jock Sanders and Noel Devine, pull for each other very hard. And freshmen are going to get better, Governor. You know, the thing is, usually a freshman such as a Noel Devine, a Jock Sanders, when they get here, they go back, revert back to their high school skills. But as they learn to read, use their vision, they become much, much better. And, you know, the ceiling is a limit for these guys.
Well, the bottom line
is a limit.
That was Jock Sanders that time, picking him a few yards inside the 20 or down to the 20-yard line.
When you have that many quality backs, when you have quarterbacks that can run as well as a back, and then you have the talent we have in the backfield, you know, we're going to put a lot of points on the board.
Plus,
West Virginia's going to put a lot of points on the board this year.
Well, they averaged at the end of last year about 40 points a game.
We need every one of them, too.
Well, that's true. At times you do. That's for sure. And it's great to see the young freshmen out there around the second-team quarterback, Jared Brown.
Look at there.
There it is. Right up the middle. Brown will score the touchdown. 20-yard run. Jared Brown from West Palm Beach, Florida. Keyed that overtime win that you were talking about, Governor, against Rutgers, but the sophomore takes it in the end zone himself.
Guy had 244 yards.
Well, watch how strong he is.
Good fake, froze the defense a little bit, and he's using his running skills here.
But that's a big boy. That's a big boy right there. And he can run hard, and he's a tough-nosed kid, too.
Well, he's 6'4", 220-pounder. He almost stumbled a little bit, still maintained his balance and got it in the end zone.
He's really a class act. I mean, he's going to be tremendous.
Joe Manchin, we thank you
John,
very
thank
much.
John, thank you. Appreciate it. Thanks for having
good
me.
Good luck. Continue.
Thank you for
success.
Doing a great job for West Virginia. We appreciate it.
No problem. Thank you, Governor.
Uh-huh. Bye-bye. Thank you all.
Mountaineers have opened it up 56-21. Everybody getting on the act. Brown, watch him slip just a little. He fooled the cameraman. Thought he was going to give it to the freshman. Takes it in himself. 56-21. Stay with us. Fifth time under Coach Rodriguez, West Virginia has scored 56 or more points. So they are very capable of doing that. Let's take another look. Good fake because he faked out our people.
zone read right here.
He doesn't have the ball, does he?
Took everyone with him, and that was a great fake that absorbs. Jock Sanders took everyone with him, and Jared Brown dances in the end zone. Five freshmen played skill positions on the last drive. Devine Sanders, wide receivers, Davis Hogan, and Will Johnson. What a future. Took it into the end zone for a score.
Yeah. 56-21. Not even midway through the fourth quarter yet. You know, the thing about, you put the second teamers in there, and they're going to want to score too. Let that one roll all the way back to West, and he has trouble with it. And West is going to be tied up at about the 17-yard line, a 5-yard return, and that's going to be it. I give Brandon West some credit. He's been in on a lot of plays today. Allen and Glover were down there on the special teams for West Virginia. About a rushing comparison. Of course, there's been a lot of passing for the Broncos, but West Virginia 268 yards. They're averaging 7 yards a carry. They've rushed it 38 times. Just over 1 yard for the Broncos.
And it shows that West Virginia stepped up big, only allowing, you know, so few yards to a team that can score points, runs the ball well, and they really, really kept them in check and shut them down. It looks like a bright future in 2007 for the Mountaineers.
Pass over the middle is caught. Making the catch is Middleton. He's a backup linebacker, and he's got enough for a first.
The thing is that, you know, you don't need the freshman, or you don't need him to play anymore, and it's better to redshirt.
Teller, you saw the center there. He is a redshirt senior from Summit, Illinois. And of course, Coach Cubitt worked down in Florida some. That pass is going to be incomplete.
Can compete for that title for the MAC.
Pass is caught for a first down. Again, it's Jamarco Simmons, who is having a, got to be close to a record afternoon for him. He is
wide receiver.
14 catches, 144 yards for him.
Jamarco show no quitting, really, when he get back, and they're not playing like a team that's trailing 56-21.
Well, 9 touchdowns put on the board by the Mountaineers in this ballgame. 4 in the first half. That pass was
to take over. You know, Patrick White, you know, he comes in situations. Jared Brown, well, he's ready for the position.
Loose ball and falling on it is Peregrine. And one of the things that they had,
thinking ahead and thinking out of the box and knowing what's going to happen, anticipating before the next play happens.
It's the 6th punt of the afternoon for the Broncos. And Rivers is able to get away from the initial tackle. Then he lost the football, and it looks like the Broncos have got it. Well, the Mountaineers turn it over for the second time. Rivers was trying to make a move, and sometimes, Renee, you try to do a little too much and you lose the handle on the ball. The play from behind that jarred the ball loose. And that pass is caught outside the 10.
Yeah, great tandem with Jamarco Simmons.
Kerrigan tries to get away, and he'll get inside the 10, pick up a couple more yards, and he's wrapped up from behind. And we have a flag on the play. He picks up 2 yards, but a flag is down.
Been impressed with the defensive front. With,
well, the numbers are good today. Just over a little over a yard per rush. Here comes some pressure. They dump it off. And the first hit was made, and down he goes. It's third down. And about 12. Peregrine sets, looks, throws far side. Catch is made. Not enough for the first down. Juan Nunez made the catch. And both these quarterbacks, Hiller and Peregrine, showing good arm strength.
You know, that out pass is not an easy toss to make. And, you know, again, credit this West Virginia defense. They, you know, started this series inside the 15-yard line and didn't give up anything. In fact, the Broncos lost a yard or two and now have to go for a field goal. So
it'll be Jones trying to replace Nate Meyer, who did an outstanding job for Western Michigan. Jones' kick is good.
And they gave it all they had coming out of the short end, but there were some positives.
It's a bouncing kick. It's going to be fielded at the 25 by Sanders. And he's knifed down as he gets across the 35-yard line. Actually, he's got almost to the 40. So the freshman, a 14-yard return for the freshman from St. Pete, Florida, Jock Sanders. He's 5'8", 185. And you look at Devine, he's 5'8", 170. He's from North Fort Myers, Florida, so you know they knew about each other when they were in high school.
That's friendly competition. They're also very hard to find, 5'8", stature. You know, they can hide pretty good behind these big, big linemen. And, you know, the offensive line for West Virginia, we talked about their zone block, and they've done so well. And the offensive line position, John, is the most misunderstood. Its effort is vital. It's the least known and misunderstood position. It must be controlled aggression. And, you know, you can tell when an offensive lineman is tired, he begins to stand up more. And I tell you what, the offensive line for West Virginia has been strong all afternoon. And second team has done just as good. There's no drop-off from the first unit to the second.
Adam Bednarik, yes, of NFL Hall of Fame cousin Chuck Bednarik, is now the quarterback. Noel Devine picked up a couple of yards. Sanders and Devine are in there at the same time. They're going to split Devine out to the right. It is Jarrett Brown out there. And Sanders for a first down to midfield. 8 yard pickup on the play.
CJ Wilson.
There's two spectacular freshmen.
First down, West Virginia.
Sanders with that 4-5 speed, 43 touchdowns his junior and senior year in St. Pete. He's just running with his abilities right now, and just his instincts are carrying both he and Devine. As they get a little, you know, more accustomed to this offense, they'll become much, much better weapons.
Alongside Jarrett Brown, Jock Sanders is the running back. Nothing there. He gets across to the 49-yard line. Brown, of course, who scored a touchdown on the last possession, dropped by Gebhardt. And I tell you what, Gebhardt's been busy in that secondary. He's made a lot of tackles.
That defensive secondary has been busy for the Broncos, and they've taken a lot of hits, made some tackles, and they've learned quite a bit playing a team like this. I think they'll take it into the season, and they'll be a much better team in week 2.
Now Sam Marone has checked in for Villagrana, who was out there for one play at the tight end spot. The direct snap. Here comes the pressure. There's the pass. Good move. There's some room at the 40. It's Jock Sanders who'll pick up a first down. It's close to the 35-yard line, a 12-yard pickup by Jock Sanders. Look for a moment as Gebhardt makes the tackle again. He might go that time.
Well, you know, you just get him out of space. You want to isolate him, and his little swing pass. And even though the defense kind of smelled it out, just to kind of, he's just got a little juke move right here as well, a little jello in his boots, and almost fumble the ball. But, boy, he is dangerous. Get him out of space, and there's no one going to bring him down.
And now it's Noel Devine back in there. And, again, it was Gebhardt who made the tackle. First down. Ball just outside the 35-yard line. Clock continues to roll down to near 2 minutes. There's the speed down the sideline, the spin move. And Devine is dropped inside the 15-yard line. That's what these fans want to see. They've read about it. They've heard about it. They watched him on YouTube. They want to see him in that old golden blue.
And I think you'll see that pirouette move a lot before he leaves Morgantown. A nice little move on the outside. And they're just running the ball. You see, he's just reading with his eyes, using his vision, getting outside, using a good, nice little pirouette. Whoop, right here. Breaks the tackle, gets inside. A nice little run, and they're knocking on the door for yet another score.
It is a 22-yard pickup. The ball is at the 14-yard line. First and 10. Clock inside. 2 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. Inside handoff. Hard hit as he gets down inside the 10.
Last year.
Noel Devine in there with Jarrett Brown in the backfield. It is second down. About 5 yards to go. Now the clock has started as we head to the final minute and a half of opening day for West Virginia and Western Michigan football. Noel Devine, he's going to score.
Number 7, Noel Devine.
Noel Devine, the freshman, takes it in from 9 yards out and expands the lead to 62-24.
Little zone read, inside read, inside zone for Devine. And
officially 8 yards on the touchdown, but it doesn't matter. He wasn't touched on the play.
He read his blocks expertly. Boy, what great blocking. Good kick out right there, inside block, and that was outstanding blocking, allowing Devine a gaping hole to get into the end zone. His first collegiate touchdown.
Well, playing briefly here, he has 7 carries and 44 yards, and he just got on the field.
You know, Bill Cuban, your heart goes out to him. He's come here twice, had 143 points scored against them and only 31 points. It's tough. It's really tough place to play. Woof.
Well, especially when you're playing a high-powered team that they have. So he took it in for the touchdown, adds to the lead. And no on the extra point, so it's 62-24 with a minute 24 remaining. And the Mountaineer and the cheerleaders doing the push-ups are going to be pooped when this one is over.
They better get used to it. As you said earlier, Patrick White promised 50 points per outing.
Well, he's lived up to it in game one.
Yeah.
First career touchdown for the freshman from North Fort Myers, Florida, Noel Devine, much highly heralded running back, along with Jock Sanders. They'll be groomed by Rich Rodriguez, and this Mountaineer offense obviously is, as you look to the future, Renee, is going to be pretty good. Of course, you've still got the other two guys who have another year eligibility left. We're talking about White
and Slate.
And Slate.
Yeah, well, I think that will be the first of many for Noel Devine. And
second most points in the Rich Rodriguez regime. Brandon West is deep. The kick is short, but it will bounce through. And West will field this one at the five. Stacked up and finally pushed out of bounds. The ball be spotted at the 27. Pat Lazier, another of the true freshmen for the men from Morgantown, made the tackle on the play on special teams. So at the 27, it'll be first down and 10.
West kind of walking off, might have a hip pointer. That was quite a collision on that kickoff return.
Sure was. Well, he has taken some blows in this game this afternoon.
He's tough, 169 pounds, and he has not, he's not given up anything. He's given it his all, and he's had a pretty good afternoon.
Peregrine and Thompson are in the backfield. Peregrine looks, throws.
Kyle.
Pass is almost intercepted. We'll have a new returner. Jock Sanders is going to be deep for the Mountaineers. He'll field it at the 20. Starts one way, tries to get outside, does. Dances back, little room, 40, 43-yard line. And a flag comes in late.
Sanders on the return. Flag on the play.
A late flag. 51-yard punt, the 23-yard return by Sanders. And we'll check out the laundry.
Personal foul. Face mask. 38 on the kicking team. 15-yard penalty.
15-yard, that's the big one. I think they've had three of those face mask penalties this afternoon.
Yeah, they have. And again, that's been very costly. Of course, the score has just made the situation worse, more of an uphill battle. But, you know, the thing about Jock Sanders, you got to like why he fits this offense so well, John, is that he played wide receiver and tailback, so he fits so smoothly into this spread option offense because they slot him out so much. He has to be a good receiver. So he's very acclimated to the position he's playing here.
22 seconds remaining on the afternoon. Well, Renee and I have had a good time here in Morgantown. They're great hosts.
Oh,
the weather's
man.
Been perfect. And we were treated to what we thought would be and was a spectacular offensive show.
Come away with this trip. Very, very happy. It's been a great experience.
And they'll go into the take a knee offense right here with Jarrett Brown running it. And Jarrett has played the entire fourth quarter. He scored a touchdown. And he will go down. And that will do it. Big, big win for West Virginia. The number three ranked team in the country. Rolls 62-24. Over the Broncos of Western Michigan. Quick handshake between the head coaches, and Rich Rodriguez has his second most productive offensive game of his 7-year regime in Morgantown. So I'm sure he's going to be pretty happy, and he should shake the hand of that number 27 because Jamarco Timmons did a terrific job for Western Michigan. We've got more to talk about. We'll be back to Mountaineer Field in Morgantown with more on a 62-24 WVU.